Auditor General still keen in auditing Guyana's oil and gas sector. FETUC throws support behind teachers if strike action resumes. Chagdeo describes National Youth Conference as a political ploy to win votes. And in sport, Guyana Cricket Board names a squad for Regional Super 50. These are the major stories we're tracking this evening. I'm Sandy Ramutar with this for Friday, September 28th edition of News Update, coming to you from outside the United Nations headquarters here in New York. The Auditor General has confirmed that he's still going to scrutinize the oil and gas sector, but this must be done with the guidance of the Canadian Executive Services Organization. He noted that his office is not ready to audit the sector. Here are the details.
Earlier in the week, the Commissioner General of the Guyana Revenue Authority, Godfrey Stacia, mentioned that his entity is going to audit the pre-contract costs of ExxonMobil. He had noted that the GRA is the only agency in Guyana that has the manpower to undertake such an audit. However, the Auditor General, Deodat Sharma, affirmed that his office will be auditing the oil and gas sector. However, this cannot be done presently as the unit is not fully prepared.
Of the two options coming from Canada, to prepare the office in terms of how we are going to audit the oil and gas sector. I wouldn't say that we are fully prepared as yet unless we have this type of preparation.
Guyana is expected to begin commercial oil production in 2020. ExxonMobil has found several large areas of quality oil-bearing sandstones that are expected to produce billions of barrels of oil. The revenue Guyana will obtain from this sector is expected to transform the country. Kipani Jordan reporting for MTV's News Update.
You're watching MTV's News Update, coming from outside the United Nations headquarters here in New York. More news on the other side of the break. Stay with us.
The sale is on at Isaac Investments. Get a 24-inch TV starting at $32,000. Trusted brands such as Insignia, Toshiba, Sharp, TCL, Vizio. 24-inch smart TV starting at $45,000. LG 65-inch 4K HD TV for $225,000. TCL 65-inch UHD TV for $220,000. Samsung 55-inch UHD TV for only $195,000. Samsung 43-inch UHD TV for $140,000. Wholesale and retail quantities available and 1-year standard warranty on all TVs sold. Amazon Fire Tablet 7-inch for $14,995 and 8-inch for $16,995. Ace, Lenovo, HP, Dell, and Asus laptops starting at $60,000 with 1-year warranty. All available at Isaac Investments. Located on the second floor of the Regent Multiplex Mall, Regent and Wellington Streets. Telephone number 231-0143 or 231-0142.
At Optive Vision Care, we value the power of your sight. And with our team of eye care professionals, you'll be in good hands. Come experience our comprehensive eye examination using state-of-the-art technology and specialized diagnostic equipment at 4 convenient locations in Mahaika, Grove, Giftland Mall, and East Street. At Optique, we care, you see. Call us today, 227-7744.
Come and get it. Water is a vital element. That is why Slim Jet introducing the latest water purifier. 7 different stages that is going to purify the water, take out all kind of bacteria like cholera, typho, coliforms, worms, pests as rust and sand and dust. Remember, your health and your family health depend on the quality of water you drink. You can get this water purifier only at the Slim Jet City Mall. Save a lot of money with the water purifier.
Just arrived at HomeSense Wholesale and Retail, Farm Public Road, a wide design of PVC ceiling panels at the most affordable prices.
So be sure to drop by. You can also catch deals on party items, baby care items, household items, footwear for ladies, gents and children, half a sacks, plastic chairs and tables, patio sets, carpets, fans, water dispensers, bicycles, trampolines, bouncy castles and much more.
HomeSense Wholesale and Retail 31 Track A Farm East Bank Demerara is your one-stop shop for everything you need.
Telephone numbers 619-8502 or 638-6861.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
Introducing the new Softex toilet tissue, now available across Guyana. Softex is silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp. Softex is soft and gentle to every touch. Even babies can use it. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. The choice is clear. Choose Softex toilet tissue, super soft and super durable, guaranteed.
Keeping homes safe across the Caribbean for decades. BOP has become the most trusted name in insecticide. There has never been, or there never will be, any escape for insects from the unrelenting power of BOP. Formulated with precision, BOP effectively eliminates all flying and crawling insects that seek to invade your home. Trust BOP, the number one insecticide brand in the Caribbean, to keep everyone that matters to you safe. Distributed by Disinco Limited.
Let FiberTech help you to renovate, refresh, and redecorate your kitchen. Spice up your kitchen with decorative colors, finishes, and accessories. Choose from an array of designs and beautiful granite colors that are blended to suit your choice. FiberTech Lifetime Kitchen is durable, termites-free, and water-resistant. Enjoy 1 year factory warranty along with our after-sales service. So come on in and let us help you choose wisely.
Dad Genius.
Dad's Genius. Welcome to KFC.
You're watching MTV's news update coming from outside the United Nations headquarters here in New York. FITUC has shown its support behind the Guyana Teachers Union, and will be backing them if strike action resumes. This follows the attempt of the Labor Department to arbitrarily appoint a chairperson of the arbitration panel that is to discuss teachers' salary increases. Here are the details.
The Federation of Independent Trade Unions of Guyana, FITUG, has come out saying that they will be supporting the Guyana Teachers Union once they recall the nationwide strike. General Secretary of the Federation, Docha Nagasar, during an exclusive interview with this newscast, said the government is using a quote-unquote delay tactic to further frustrate teachers. He was at the time referring to the failure of the government to establish the arbitration panel to discuss the increases for teachers.
Dealing tactic is used is that the ministry does not want to sit down and negotiate with the GTU, which according to labor practices, they have to do.
The GTU has signaled that it does not support the unilateral decision of the Labor Department to appoint Dr. Leland as the chairman of the arbitration panel. Nagasar is convinced that this is yet another manifestation of the ministry's and administration's attempt to undermine the teachers and the union struggle. Only yesterday, opposition leader Barjagdeo called out to President Granger to make a decision on the issue of salary increases for teachers. He had also asked that the president muzzle Minister Keith Scott. Siding with Jagdeo on this call, Nagasar said that the government should reconsider the decision to have Minister Scott in charge of labor. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
As production for oil and gas fast approaches, there is a great need for the government to implement a local content legislation. This is according to oil expert attorney at law Charles Rumson Jr., who told a news conference today that the economic welfare of the people of Guyana should be the government's top priority while undertaking the oil industry. Lashana Gomes-Kernunis has more.
Criticizing the lateness of the Sovereign Wealth Fund by 3 years, attorney-at-law Charles Rumson Jr. earlier today explained that a local content legislation as well as a national depletion policy must be put in place to oversee the country's emerging oil and gas sector. Rumson strongly believes without a local content legislation, there will remain ample loopholes where Guyanese stand to lose. Rumson explained before any other contracts are signed with other oil and gas exploration companies, the stabilization clause should be relooked. He argued what should be of serious concern is the fact up until now, there is no petroleum committee, no Ministry of Oil to help govern the sector, no strong environmental agency to deal with the potential of an oil spill disaster, and no proper functioning and capable and auditing department at the Guyana Revenue Authority, nor the Ministry of Finance.
There is no local content legislation. I had a meeting with the GCCI yesterday, with the Minister of Business, along with Dr. Bino, who heads the Department of Energy. And rather than arguing for local content, they're arguing why we should not have local content. And since we are on the subject, let me just say that Guyana and Guyanese people, at this point in time, should have been far richer now that we are about to start producing oil. But it could only have happened if we had a local content legislation.
On top of that, Rumson indicated if Guyana had reaped just 10% of the proceeds of the Liza Phase 1 well, the country would have been in a much better position financially. He indicated that it is worrying that foreign companies have also noticed the dangers of Guyana not strongly pushing for the local content legislation.
Foreign companies are coming into Guyana and saying that your government is not even aggressive and firm about your local content position and the mandatory requirements to hire Guyanese people or to capture a share of the procurement from the operator. So they're saying they don't have to do it. In fact, there's no requirement for those companies to even register their company in Guyana. They just have to register with the portal.
Rumson asserted that the government is in effect forsaking the interest of Guyanese when it goes about the sole interest of revenues. Reporting for MTV News Update, Lashona Gomes, Cornelius.
Opposition leader Bharat Jagdeo is convinced that the hosting of the National Youth Conference is a political ploy by the government to secure votes at the local government election. He reminded of the failed promises the government made for youths.
The National Youth Conference officially opened on Wednesday, September 28, with youths engaged in community development issues. While this seems to augur well for national development, the opposition party believes the time was strategically chosen by the government to win the hearts of youths. This will in turn assist them with more votes at the local government election.
It's all an election gimmick. If you imagine they now are soliciting youth perspective on empowerment and development, what about your promises to young people? Should you not start with that?
Jagdeo further reminded the government that they have failed the young people. To make matters worse, he repeated the sentiments shared by the president during his address to youths.
You have not done free education that you promised. You've made it harder for them to go to the University of Ghana by increasing the fees. You're going after people who have defaulted on their student loan. Two, you promised them jobs. And then we lost 30,000 jobs, and you said, that's not my responsibility. Look at the president in the interview. Not my responsibility. And now they're lazy, he told the young people at BV.
Jagdeo stated that employment overall is not available to persons, especially for young people who have little to no experience. As such, he is urging youths to see past the alleged divisiveness of the government. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
Guyana Today expresses optimism at the 73rd United Nations General Assembly that Venezuela will change its decision and participate in the International Court of Justice case in the border controversy case. Minister of Foreign Affairs Carl Greenidge today reminded world leaders of his commitment to the resolution of the long-standing Guyana-Venezuela border controversy. He was at the time addressing the 73rd sitting of the United Nations General Assembly in Manhattan, New York, on behalf of President David Granger. Noting that the rule of law must prevail, Greenidge said he's looking forward for the final judgment by the International Court of Justice.
Venezuela has thus far refused to participate in the proceedings. Guyana sincerely hopes that it will change its mind. There is still time for it to do so.
In March of this year, Guyana filed its application in the court seeking an affirmation of the validity of the 1899 arbitral award and the international boundary that it established. The Caribbean Court of Justice has fixed November 19, 2018 and April 2019 as the respective time limits for the filing of a memorial and a counter-memorial by the Bolivarian Republic, but Venezuela indicated that it will not participate in the court's proceeding as the court must first address the question of jurisdiction. You're watching MTV's News Update, coming to you from outside the United Nations headquarters here in New York. More news on the other side of the break. Stay with us.
Hey, you have a growing flesh there, and there too, and there is another one. Those ugly and annoying growing flesh, like a plague, ignoring them, and before you know, you have them everywhere. SlimJet, presenting Coleomac, the most effective growing flesh and wart remover. Painlessly remove ugly growing flesh is the quick and effective way. Get soft, smooth, growing flesh-free skin, guarantee. Just apply Coleomac twice a day and the growing flesh just dry up and fall off. Easy, quick, and painless. Stop suffering and feeling embarrassed. Remove those ugly growing flesh with Coleomac. Only at the SlimJet, City Mall, second floor.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick bet for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
You minding me business? I noticed you yesterday, you're there watching. Today you're there here again. Why you minding me business? I fed up of your nosy self.
Yeah, baby, I just love your windows.
Why you bad eyeing me window? Like you housing a window? What kind of window really in your house?
I got some old Louvers windows that I need to change.
Louvers? Best it. People still got Louvers windows. Girl, I let you in for a secret, right? Beeson got a special deal right now. You go down there, you buy 10 window, you get a free bathroom window. Oh, for the love of God, throw them louvers window and go down to Beeson and modernize.
Beeson Windows and Doors, serving Guyana with the highest quality windows for your home, office, or commercial building.
Staying on treatment for HIV can lead to a normal, healthy life. Remain on treatment once you've started. Don't share or use someone else's pills. staying on your medication not only helps to improve your quality of life, but decreases the risk of HIV transmission to others. A message from USAID, PEPFAR, Advancing Partners and Communities Guyana, NAPS, and the Ministry of Public Health.
Save on your next electricity bill by installing LED lights. LEDs last longer, emit a more natural and brighter light, and consume less power compared to other types of lights. LEDs are ideal for solar systems. At Gafur's, they're available in 2 and 4 feet tubes, recessed lamps, ceiling and surface mounted panel lights, area lights, bulbs, chandelier sizes and larger, floodlights, spotlights, high bay lamps, and pole-mounted outdoor lights. All of our LED lights can work with either 110 or 220 volts and can be fitted into existing sockets, making upgrades simple and easy. For the hot weather, you need AC units. Now available, MyDia AC units in split system or inverter types from 12,000 BTU to 36,000 BTU. Our inverter units are rated 19 SEER, which means they consume less power, whilst giving higher outputs than those offered by most competitors. Great news! We now offer free labor installation depending on areas, and you can get a 10% discount on parts needed for installation. For more information, contact Mr. Mirai on 226-5719 at Gafur's, the name you can trust.
Did you know almost one-third of deaths in Guyana are heart-related? Chronic inflammation is the root cause of atherosclerosis, the process that leads to cholesterol-clogged arteries. You can now lower high triglyceride levels with Omega XL and reduce the dangerous inflammation that causes these problems. So to ensure a healthy heart and reduce your risk of disease, get your Omega XL today. Live long, stay strong with Omega XL.
Everything is connected, our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Puran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
Mom's Genius. Welcome to KFC.
Welcome back. You're watching MTV's news update coming from outside the United Nations headquarters here in New York. The Auditor General report has been presented to the Speaker of the National Assembly for the 8th consecutive year. This report will be presented to the National Assembly before it is made public.
Today, the Auditor General, Deodat Sharma, presented the annual report for the year 2017 to the Speaker of the National Assembly, Dr. Barton Scotland. This was presented timely, as the statutory deadline for submitting the report is September 30.
This achievement reflects the realization of the Office objective of timely reporting of the results of the audits to the legislature and ultimately to the public.
The Auditor General, during his brief speech, claimed that some entities' audits are still in backlog. The report has to be laid in the National Assembly by Dr. Scotland before it becomes a public document. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
Guyana today briefed the 73rd United Nations General Assembly about the importance of signing the Treaty for the Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons, which was initiated in September 2017. During his address to the 73rd United Nations General Assembly, Minister of Foreign Affairs Carl Greenidge cited a disarmament agenda as a central tenet for achieving a stable, secure and peaceful nation. Demonstrating its commitment to the United Nations disarmament agenda, Guyana was the first member state to sign on to the Treaty for the Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons. The foreign minister said the decision was rooted in the government's conviction for the total elimination of nuclear weapons.
And the onus is on all of us to fulfill the obligations we have taken on ourselves by becoming states parties to the various legal instruments concerned with questions of disarmament and non-proliferation.
He said the illicit trade in small arms and light weapons and their associated ammunition poses one of the most serious threats to human security and sustainable development. The foreign minister pointed to drug trafficking, transactional organized crime and unregulated cyberspace as factors diverting resources that could otherwise be invested.
We believe that with effective international cooperation and assistance, small countries like Guyana can tackle this illicit trade and ultimately create safer communities, safer countries and regions, and a safer world.
The Treaty for the Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons is the first legally binding international agreement to comprehensively prohibit nuclear weapons with the goal of leading towards total elimination. The Three Rivers Kids Foundation earlier today donated two state-of-the-art reclining and automated wheelchairs to children with spina bifida and cerebral palsy. The Shana Gomes Carlinas reports.
According to Rabindra Singh, whose 15-year-old daughter was diagnosed with cerebral palsy from birth, receiving the reclining wheelchair from the foundation will greatly assist in the mobility of his child. Singh encouraged other families in need of support to seek out the Three Rivers Kids Foundation with the hope they too can be assisted.
We always need a special need chair for my daughter, Cassandra Singh, and it will come in good use for her to move her around. Commending the organization to those who suffering like my daughter kids so they could assist them also.
General Secretary of the Three Rivers Kids Foundation, Lita Guidine, explained that the wheelchairs were only sourced after each parent had sent in critical information to the foundation regarding their children's individual medical condition. Guidine indicated that the foundation is hopeful that the donated wheelchairs will serve each child to the fullest capacity and functionality, aiding them in the ease of mobility.
I must say, on behalf of Three Rivers Kids Foundation, I am very happy and proud for donating these chairs to these needy people because I know it would be beneficial and good use to them. Well, they went into our office here on Wolford Avenue and explained to me what it is, and they had to fill up an application form which I filed in Canada. And Mrs. Singh was here in February and they came in too. And she saw the child and she knew exactly what they need, and she organized it over there to post them to Guyana.
The Three Rivers Kids Foundation, which was first founded in 2005 by executive member of the foundation, Jeanette Singh, has sought to help many children facing varying illnesses and disabilities. Some needing urgent medical intervention and others with assistance in garnering help in devices such as wheelchair, crutches and others. Just a few months ago, the foundation aided several children in traveling to India for various medical assistance in the categories of eye, kidney, and heart surgeries. Reporting for MTV News Update, Lashona Gomes, Cornelius.
Here is Skippany Jordan with today's weekly entertainment guide.
Watch me dancing on you. Music, like a lot, I don't know. I don't be eight, so I get low. I know you want me higher, so when I wine fast, wine slow. Only man say,
the entertainment and events managers of Movietown Guyana have embarked on a venture to look for Guyanese talent in an effort to offer persons a chance to showcase their talent on the big stage.
What we're looking for is trying to reach out to the Guyanese population, and I'm looking for your talent. I'm looking for the best that you have to offer because it's one of the opportunities, apart from the movies that we're offering at Movietown, we're also offering young, upcoming talent a space to perform and to be seen and to be showcased.
Events and entertainment manager Heathcliff West said they are looking to host the Fiesta Night at least twice a week and re-emphasized that the events will be child-friendly and family-oriented, so no explicit content will be showcased. West added, even though the main source of talent will be from Guyana, they might bring talents from Trinidad and some international talents in the future.
Well, just go onto my Facebook page, Movietown Guyana, and then also upload to my Fiesta Plaza at Movietown, that's TOWNE.com, Fiesta Plaza Movietown.com, and send me what you have. Whatever talent that you have, just keep it child friendly, just keep it family oriented, because that's the type of entertainment we're looking for.
So ensure you drop in those submissions, because the deadline is October 7, 2018. Join us next Friday for another edition of MTV's Entertainment Guide.
Here is Celine Griffith with today's court roundup.
A 44-year-old minibus driver was this morning remanded to prison for raping a 21-year-old woman who is mute. Sherwin Reynolds of Pleasance East Coast Demerara made his appearance before the chief magistrate, Ann McLennan, and was not required to plead to the charge. It is alleged that Reynolds on April 19, 2018, in Temeri, engaged in sexual penetration with the woman without her consent. He was represented by attorney-at-law Stanley Moore and was remanded to prison until October 10. A 38-year-old Charleston Baker was today remanded to prison after being busted by Custom Anti-Narcotics Unit officers with $1.1 million worth in cannabis. Colin Denny, who was released 4 months ago for a similar charge, appeared before Chief Magistrate Ann McLennan and pleaded not guilty to trafficking 2.3 kilograms of cannabis on September 26 at Church Street. His attorney, George Thomas, during an application for bail, told the court that his client was not arrested with the drugs in his possession, but it was a minibus driver who was busted with the drugs. Kanu prosecutor Kiyono Sandiford, during her objection to bail, told the court that the driver was arrested a day after Denny and was taken into custody. Sandiford noted that there is also surveillance footage of the transaction. Denny, based on objections raised, was remanded to prison until October 15. Reporting for MTV News Update, Celine Griffith.
Coming up after the break, MTV's Sports Update and more. Stay with us.
The secret is out. Tyo's Future Shop is the absolute best place to shop if you're looking for quality products at the lowest prices in the widest possible variety. Choose from a vast array of custom-made quality wooden furniture in endless designs. Electrical and household appliances, clothing, cell phones and accessories, and much, much more.
Oh my God, so much in this store.
Tayo's Future Shop and Household Appliances, located at Anna Katerina, West Coast, Demerara. Free delivery available.
Credit, now me know the secret.
I like all you know the secret. Everybody know the secret.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
But I can't feel it, so I guess I just won't get it. Lewis Styles. Simply different.
Mark?
I'm in the kitchen.
This is amazing! I love your tiles.
Make an impression with the finest tiles imported by Lens. Lens has a huge selection of various tiles for your wall, floor, and pool needs. All of our tiles are of grade A quality, which are the highest quality tile rated. That means they last longer and are less likely to damage or crack. We're the sole distributor for many reputable companies around the world. At Lens, we have special deals for contractors and bulk shoppers. Shop at any of our three locations to get the best in tiles. Lens, our product, your creation.
Looking for fresh meals, tasty pastries and bread? Then visit Pam and Steve Bakery at 127 4th Street in Stone Avenue, Campbellville. Come and enjoy our daily breakfast and lunch specials. Choose from our wide variety of delightful meals. For the Christmas holidays, place your order for our black sponge and fruitcakes. Be sure to drop by for our Sunday breakfast special, pepper pot and more. Opens every day except holidays. So next time you're in town, remember to visit Pam and Steve Bakery or call us on 226-5338.
Tell.
Disclosure is important. Encouraging a partner to test can be life-saving. Disclosing or encouraging a partner to test does not have to be your sole responsibility. Professionals can help.
So, you can call and tell them for me?
Yes.
Thank you.
I will tell. I just need some time.
I am HIV positive.
Don't let your doubts and fears get the best of you. Having the other person know their status is just as important as you knowing yours. Partner testing is not only for the other person, but also for you. Encourage your partners to test and disclose.
At GBTI, quality customer service is our number one goal. That's why with our 24-hour depository facility, you can deposit your end-of-day sales at your convenience. Visit any of our branches to sign up for our night depository service. GBTI, your friend, your bank.
Welcome to Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., Guyana's sole distributor of NP and Ultra Lubricants, SKF bearings, seal and belts, international trucks and parts, and Napa batteries. With a bond capacity of 30,000 square foot, we offer superior brands at affordable prices and the best after-sale service. ISG supplies sustainable integrated solutions to make your business a growing success. Visit us at our new main office at Lot 4Q, Peters Hall, ISG, the best opportunity to make the right choice.
Welcome back. You're watching MTV's Sports Update. The senior national selectors of the Ghana Cricket Board, GCB, on Friday afternoon announced what they deemed golden picks for the upcoming regional Super 50 competition.
The Guyana Super 50 squad, to be led by veteran Leon Johnson, will depart Guyana on Sunday to compete in the 16 tournament starting in early October in Trinidad. The Guyana Cricket Board, in a statement today, said after an exciting competition in the 2018 GCB CGI Jaguars 50 over league, the selectors have made their golden picks to represent the Guyana Jaguars based on performances from all eight franchises. Wicketkeeper batsman Anthony Bramble has been appointed Johnson's deputy, while opening batsman Trevon Griffith, who has been in fine form of recent, makes a return to national colors. Budding talents Kemal Savery and Ronaldo Ali Mohamed have been placed on the reserve list and will join the team as selected players will depart to fulfill their duties on the Windies tour to India. The squad comprises of Leon Johnson, captain, Anthony Bramble, vice-captain, Tejnarayan Chanderpaul Hemraj, Raymond Reefer, Sherfane Rutherford, Christopher Barnwell, Romario Shepherd, Veerasamy Permal, Gudakesh Moti, Ramal Lewis, Ricardo Adams, Trevon Griffith and Clinton Pestano. The team is led by coach Yusen Crandon and manager assistant coach Rayon Griffith. They will be accompanied by physiotherapist Neil Barry. Chelsea Griffith reporting for MTV's Sports Update.
Following the 2018 Milo Football Skills Tournament, where five young players were allowed the opportunity to win a grand prize of traveling to Barcelona, young Ian Daniels is the only Guyanese among the five allowed for the chance of a lifetime.
In 2016, Barcelona Football Club and Nestle Milo agreed to develop a range of special activations based on their core value teamwork. By incorporating the unique playing style of Barcelona, it was believed that much would be injected into the programs and some 22.5 million Milo grassroots sports program children will have the opportunity of a lifetime while staying active in a fun and healthy way. After last year's program, that was held in August, three young players were allowed an experience of their lifetime with an all-expense-paid trip to Spain's Barcelona soccer school. The tournament this year was hosted in June, where more than 160 boys and girls aged 7 to 12 were judged based on their skill sets so that five young players were allowed a similar opportunity. Guyana's Ian Daniels was among those five after he delivered a phenomenal performance, allowing him to walk away with the grand prize. Daniels will be traveling tomorrow to Barcelona, Spain for an opportunity of a lifetime, along with the four other young winners from Jamaica, Barbados and Trinidad and Tobago, and two representatives from Nestle. Chelsea Griffith reported for MTV's Sports Update.
There is much more in store for the further expansion of the Lusignan Golf Course, and if all goes according to plan, there can be an 18-hole golf course as early as next year.
Since the beginning of the year, the Lusignan Golf Course has seen a number of events and tournaments. Yesterday, at the official launching of the 2018 Guyana Open Tournament at the Marriott Hotel, it was brought to the media's attention that golf legend Jack Nicklaus will be constructing an 18-hole golf course in Guyana. Guest speaker, Minister of Social Cohesion Dr. George Norton, during his closing speech informed the media that Nicklaus is quite impressed with what the golf club has accomplished thus far.
He was impressed with the work that Alim is doing, because they tend to follow golf across the globe. While I agree with Sonia that we should embrace the course, we need to improve and get it extended. And that dream, that desire, is taken up by Mr. Jack Nicklaus, who has promised, because of what he's saying, that he, with his own financing, his own efforts, will sponsor the establishment of the 18-hole golf course.
Dr. Norton highlighted that while here in Guyana there is access to land, it is unfortunate that there is only a 9-hole golf course. However, he added, with the help of Nicklaus, if all goes according to plan, we can have an 18-hole golf course as early as next year. Chelsea Griffith reporting for MTV's Sports Update.
And finally in sports, high-ranked Chinese Taipei team crushed Guyana's male in the fourth round of the 43rd World Chess Olympiad 2018.
Yesterday, the fourth round of the 43rd World Chess Olympiad saw Guyana going down against higher-ranked Chinese Taipei team. Tafin Khan managed a draw against higher-rated Raymond Song. Despite a few lapses during the game, some accurate playing from Khan ensured he secured some rating points and honor for Guyana. His partners Drayton, Loris Nathu, and Glenford Corlett lost to Adelard Bai, Chin Yang, and Yang Ye Liu, respectively. Meanwhile, the Guyana female team was squashed by the dominant Jordan chess players. Surprisingly, Guyana female national champion Maria Verona Thomas was outplayed in the endgame by Ode Asil. Her partners Sharifa Ali and Sasha Sharif were defeated by Al Nemat Raya and Al Shebi Boshra, respectively, while Nalisha Johnson fell shortly. After the fourth round, the Guyana men's team has dropped to 158 on the standings with 4 points, while the women's team falls to 127 with 4.5 points. Chelsea Griffith reported for MTV's Sports Update.
And that's our sports package for this evening. Stay with us, more news after the break.
Welcome to Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., Guyana's sole distributor of NP and Ultra Lubricants, SKF bearings, seal and belts, international trucks and parts, and Napa batteries. With a bond capacity of 30,000 square foot, we offer superior brands at affordable prices and the best after-sale service. ISG supplies sustainable integrated solutions to make your business a growing success. Visit us at our new main office at Lot 4Q, Peters Hall, ISG, the best opportunity to make the right choice.
We now take a look at the Guyana Stock Exchange for closing prices, trading session 792. Let's turn our attention to the Demerara and Barbies Riverboat schedules. That's a wrap on today's broadcast. Before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. Auditor General still keen on auditing Guyana's oil and gas sector. FEDOC throws support behind teachers if strike action resumes. JAGDU describes National Youth Conference as a political ploy to win votes. And in sport, Guyana Cricket Board names squad for regional Super 50. Catch our rebroadcast at 23 hours today and at 6 hours 30 tomorrow. On behalf of our news and technical teams, I'm Sandy Ramutar, thanking you for watching. Have a good night.